Yo, what's poppin', everybody? My name is Smudger. Welcome back to another video. Before this video starts, I would like to let everyone know I'm doing a 3,500 crown giveaway. If you're interested in that, links down in the description. So if you're interested in just, you know, click that guy and yeah, let's get started. So recently, a Wiz dev diary just came out, or recently, kind of like that. And it's mainly about PvP, but there's a tad bit in there that's about PvE, and that's the reason why I'm making this video. I know that a lot of people are giving this update a lot of hate, and I personally like the update, and mainly because I don't know a lot about PvP, and it is considered a PvP update. Since I don't know a lot about PvP, that might, you know, make me a little bit ignorant towards what's actually going on here. But on the PvE side of things, I think that this is a good update. So if you guys have not read the dev diary of the new update, I'm gonna leave a link down in the description so you guys can click that. But I'm just gonna cover over a few things that stood out to me. First of all, this message right here that says, before I do that, I would like to provide a TLDR version to our PvE players that will explain how these PvP changes will affect PvE. They won't. You can go to Diego to train a new spell we discussed below, but you probably won't need it. With that being said, ours, that already tells you a lot of information about what's actually going on here. It's not a PvE update, it is a PvP update, but the main thing is they're adding a new spell to the game, and this spell is supposed to only affect PvP, but it also affects PvE. The new spell that they're adding is called Solar Surge, which is a plus 50 damage per pip, 25 minimum and 30 max. They explained the spell by being wind drawn from your main deck and used to enchant an attack spell also draws from your main deck. Solar Surge adds a plus 50 damage per pip to the attack spell. Technically, the spell will support 0 pip attack spells as well, adding a plus 25 damage. The maximum value that Solar Surge can provide is plus 300 damage, requiring a spell of at least rank 6. A troll spell, 2 pips will add only 100 damage. Glow bugs, 6 pips, 1 shadow pip can add the full 300 damage. With that being said, basically, in my opinion or in my mind, this is basically adding all of the enchants that we currently have into the game into one singular card. We're talking about strong, we're talking about gargantuan, we're talking about epic. They're all combined in this one card. Now you might be asking, how does this help PvE? Why is this necessary for PvE? What does this have to do with PvE? If you guys don't know, this doesn't affect max level PvE at all. It mainly just affects wizards that are leveling or wizards that are new to the game and are looking for a better enchant to do more damage in PvE situations as they are leveling throughout the world. To put this in perspective, the only enchant or the first enchant that you get, which is strong, is a plus 100 damage enchant that you unlock at level 100, that you unlock at level 50, not 100, level 50, my bad. But yeah, you unlock the strong enchant card at level 50 in Celestial. With that being said, it's not provided here, but a little birdie told me that the only way to get Solar Surge is you have to be a level 50 and you also have to be a veteran in PvP. If you have this spell at level 50, you pretty much have an epic card. I'm currently on my Ice Wizard and I'm level 60 now, but I believe once I was inside the 50 through 60 range, I already had Colossal, which is a six pip spell, and I already had Frost Giant, which is a 7 pip spell. So I could literally take this card on my wizard and already have my epic enchant down. I could pretty much put an epic enchant on my Colossus and my Frost Giant. And I'm not even level 110, which is the level you need to unlock the epic enchant. This basically provides a faster way of getting the epic enchant as long as you're willing to put the work in. And when I say willing to put the work in, it's mainly going towards the fact that you have to be a veteran in PvP to even get this spell. Personally, I'm not going to win a lot of PvP matches. I suck at PvP, and a little birdie told me that it will take you around 6 to 7 wins to get veteran, and I don't think I can get 6 to 7 wins as a level 50 to get veteran, so I could get this spell and just use it in PvE until I'm level 110 to actually get the real epic enchant. However, if you're good at PvP and you're willing to go inside of PvP with your level 50 wizard, win 6 to 7 matches, get veteran, get this spell, I'm pretty sure from level 50 to level 110 you will use this spell to enchant all of your cards, because it's a free epic. You know, it's literally a free epic card for low level wizards. and PvE. That's how I see it. But yeah, that's why I made this video, to let you guys know about this card. I think it's a good update for the PvE side. Even though it doesn't directly affect PvE, I still think it affects PvE in some way, in some light. But yeah, the rest of this update is just PvP stuff, which I don't PvP, so it doesn't really affect me that much. But if you guys want to look at it, a link will be down in the description, so you can click it and watch, or not watch, but read what everything has changed and stuff. But yeah, hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. If you disagree with what I said in this video, let me know down in the comments of why you think Solar Surge is bad for PvP or PvE, or why it doesn't affect PvE as much as I think it does. Let me know what you guys think, and I will see you guys in the next video. Thank you for watching. Have a great day, and peace.